Hello, my name is Beth Dixon, and this is a video series based on Vicki Borlaug's PowerPoint presentation on normal distribution. And in this PowerPoint, we will be finding probability given data values. I wish to thank Mrs. Borlaug for allowing me to use her PowerPoint to make this set of videos. Example number one. A chef is famous for his mango-flavored hard candy. Assume the temperature, called hard crack stage, he uses to make this candy is normally distributed with a mean of 302.3 degrees and a standard deviation of 1.2 degrees. If one batch of his mango-flavored hard candy is randomly selected, find the probability that the temperature is greater than 301.5 degrees. And yes, it says chief and not chef. I corrected one, but not the other. Maybe he's the chief chef. The first thing you want to do is to draw your normal curve. Once you've drawn your normal curve, remember that the number line underneath that is the X's, and you want to label that the temperatures, because what we're talking about is the temperatures. Then we want to place and label that the mean. And I'm going to try to draw on here the little symbol for mean, and that doesn't much look like the mean, but that's mu for mean underneath that. And so the mu or mean is 302.3 degrees as given in our problem, and we have a standard deviation of 1.2. And I always like to write those down with a curve and labeled. That takes it out of the words and puts it in your own handwriting. Once we have the mean and the standard deviation labeled, we want to label the X. What are we talking about here? This problem wants us to find the probability that the temperature is greater than 301.5 degrees. So label 301.5. That would be below the 302, and since we want that greater than, we'll shade above the 301, and that would shade all the way to the right. So the answer we're looking for in the shaded area is to the right. Next, label underneath the X line the Z values, and we will want to find the Z value that corresponds to the 301.5, remembering that every X value has a corresponding Z value. And if X equals 301.5, we will need to find its Z value. Remember that our formula for Z is Z equals X minus the mean over the standard deviation, or X minus mu over sigma. That gives us Z equals 301.5 minus 302.3 for the mean divided by 1.2 for the standard deviation. Using our calculator to calculate that, that gives us negative 0.67 as our Z value. We will look that up in our standard normal chart, remembering that we use a chart that shades to the left. So the area to the left of that Z score is 0.2514. And that's the area to the left. Since we are not looking for the area to the left, and we are looking for the area to the right, we will need to subtract 1 minus 0.2514 to get 0.7486 as our answer. Be sure as you're doing these problems that you block in, circle, or somehow indicate what your final answer is. There is a lot of work that can really be busy, and you want to indicate to your teacher what your final answer is. Circling or blocking in your answer is very helpful. If one batch of the Chiefs or Chef's mango flavored hard candy is randomly selected, there is a 0.7486 probability that the temperature is greater than 301.5. Let's look at example number 2. The amount of cleaner that the Sparkle Window Company uses to clean the Commerce Building has a mean of 5.8 gallons and a standard deviation of 0.7 gallons. Assume the amount of cleaner used is normally distributed. If one time the company cleans the Commerce Building is randomly selected, find the probability that the company uses between 5.0 and 7.0 gallons of window cleaner. Again, the first step is to draw your normal curve. Once we've drawn it, label your mean. And once again, I'm going to try to take the pen here and label that mu, and that looks a little bit better. And so that's our mean of 5.8, and we have a standard deviation of 0.7. Again, label that at your curve. It'll be much easier to find than trying to read that from the words of the problem. Once we've labeled that, notice that we want to find the area or the probability, both being the same thing, the probability that the company uses between 5 and 7 gallons. Mark those on your number line appropriately, 5 being below 5.8 and 7 being above. Don't worry so much about being to scale, but just mark them. Then we want to shade between those because that's what we're looking for. So our answer will be between those two values. Then we'll mark our z-score, and we'll need to find an corresponding z value for each x value. First, let's find the z value for 5. If x equals 5, our z score is x minus mu over the standard deviation, or x minus the mean, x minus mu over sigma, or x minus the mean over the standard deviation, which would give us 5.0 minus 5.8 divided by 0.7. That gives us negative 1.14 for our first z value. The area to the left, if we look up negative 1.14 in our table, is given as 0.1271. And that's the area to the left of the 5.0. And notice that area we have outlined in blue and drawn an arrow to that area. Notice how and where that area is. Now let's repeat that process for x equals 7.0. Same formula, x minus mu over the sigma, 7.0, this time with our x being 7.0, minus the mean of 5.8 divided by 0.7, the standard deviation. Calculate that out and we get z equals 1.71. Look that up in our table. Our table gives us the area to the left as 0.9564, and we will highlight that area, the area to the left of 1.71, and therefore to the left of 7.0, and highlight that in red, and the area to the left is 0.9564. Notice our answer is shaded in blue, light blue, but the highlighted areas are neither of the answers from our table. What we need to do is take the area highlighted in red and subtract out the area highlighted in blue. To find between, we subtract table minus table. So we will need to take, and to find our answer, subtract 0.9564, subtract 0.1271. That gives us our answer as 0.8293. And our answer is, if one of time the company cleans the Commerce Building is randomly selected, there's a 0.8293 probability that the company will use between 5.0 and 7.0 gallons of window cleaner. Here are the exercises that go with this set. And here are the answers for those. If you have Miss Borlaug and she's using these, or another teacher that is using these for homework, and you will need to be turning these in, you will not get credit for just these decimal answers. So I thought it appropriate to provide those answers for you to check. If you have a teacher where you're using the calculator, I thought I would provide those. Those are the tech answers or the technology answers that follow, so that you could practice checking those as well. You can pause there and check your answers for those. Or if you're practicing checking your answers, you'll see that you're just slightly off if you use technology, or slightly more accurate. It's a rounding issue. But these are a way for you to check your answers. Whoops, I went right by my picture, but that's okay. Thank you for watching. And as always, if you are a Walter State student and need additional help, please feel free to stop by and see me in the math lab in MBSS 222. And again, thank you.